Here are some local corporate headlines. The Philippine Tax Appeals Court denies Procter & Gamble a 46 million peso tax refund as it found no compelling justification to disturb the earlier decision. The court says PNG sales and services outside the Philippines did not comply with the requisites of a valid zero-rated sale under Philippine tax laws. The FMCG firm filed for the tax refunds in 2014 and 2015, but these were denied in 2017. Meanwhile, EEI Power partners with Sysnet integrators to operate and offer an integrated electric vehicle charging system. EEI will have a 40% stake while Sysnet will develop the charging system and own its rights and licenses. EEI shares rose 0.2% in Friday trade. ASEN inks an omnibus loan and security agreement with its subsidiaries for a loan facility amounting to 600 million pesos. The deal between ASEN, Visayas Renewables, and Montes Solar Energy aims to finance Montes' permanent working capital and other corporate purposes. ASEN shares closed lower by 0.3%. And finally, Leandro Leviste's SP Nueva Ecija Corporation confirms it is in talks with various stakeholders to raise its public float to the stock exchange's required minimum of 20%. Leviste says they have identified potential buyers for at least 2.12 billion common shares via a private placement. The PSE suspended SPNEX trading on June 3 after its public float fell below the required 20% due to its share swap deal with parent firm Solar Philippines.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. urges a private sector advisory council to address the need for green energy amid a growing demand for electric vehicles in the country. During a Thursday meeting in Malacañang, Marcos said collaboration between the private and public sector could make the Philippines a major player in the global e-vehicle industry. But he noted sourcing green power for the vehicles may pose a challenge to production. The PSAC Jobs Sectors Group will be looking into 17 downstream and upstream industry development opportunities, including mining in the EV value chain.
Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Hawaiian Electric after Moody's downgraded its credit rating to junk status amid worries about the utility firm's potential role in the Maui wildfires. Shares of Hawaiian Electric are down 1% in pre-market trade. Also in focus, Moderna says its new COVID vaccine was effective against the Aries variant in early trial. Shares of the biotech firm are up 0.7% before the bell. We're also keeping a close watch on China-exposed luxury heavyweights like LVMH amid heightened concerns of weak economic growth in the second-largest economy. Shares of the French fashion house are trading in the red at 774.80 euros apiece. We're also keeping an eye on Chinese EV maker XPeng after it reported a wider-than-expected loss in the second quarter. XPeng shares plunged 6% in pre-market trading.
Malaysian markets posted their third straight week of losses as China Evergrande's bankruptcy filing raised more worries about Beijing's economic health. The Hong Kong Hang Seng led declines, closing in bear market territory. It's now down more than 20% below the highs of January. Japan's Nikkei 225 saw smaller losses after data showed core inflation fell in July, while headline inflation remained unchanged. Some notable stock movements in the region: shares of China Evergrande subsidiaries tumbled following the bankruptcy news. Its property management service provider plunged as much as 20% before paring losses to 9%. The group's automobile manufacturer, meanwhile, saw its share slump 16%. Here at home, Philippine shares were not spared from the bloodbath. The main index lost more than 1%, logging a four-week losing streak.
With the lack of optimism and investors' confidence, we are actually plotting our key support areas at the 6200.
Okay.
Downturns could still continue due to the lackluster environment that we are in. Actually, we are currently at the lowest level year to date, and this really just reflects the pessimism on the overall outlook on the economy. Looking at the technicals as well, indicators are leaning towards bearishness. It all points out that the bleeding could still continue as the selling pressure is still heavy. And yeah, no hints that the bulls are entering. So with that, we could easily hit the 6,200 area.